establish, let's say, courses to improve the competency of people working in Qatar, we need to do this, this work. And we need your participation. Importance BEAM related challenge in Qatar include lack of in-house expertise, and this is, if we look around here, most of people here are expats, maybe one or two, I don't know. So this is the expertise is not the availability of skilled staff and availability of training. Right now I have no information about some training going on in Qatar, so both of people learn by doing or they go abroad to learn something, to learn about BEAM. Consistent with international survey, this is very important. Qatar as a proxy for international construction industry due to diverse set of international companies operating in Qatar. So here we have also companies coming from all over the world, from Australia to China to everywhere. So this is really diverse operator here. So in what are the challenge for BEAM adoption in Qatar, the construction industry. First, you see the first is the lack of in-house, which goes for the highest level. This is the about more than 19% numbers of respondents. No, it more than 67%. So it's the highest 65, a bit more than 65, or let's say 65%. So this is what we want to tackle, and we want to find out what really, what kind of training, what is the set of training that we need to establish. So it's a three-year project. We have done the literature review the first year, yes, mostly, and we have done a testing. We have a test interview for a limited number to see if our tools is good. The aim of this project is twofold: develop and apply a novel performance-driven approach for assessing, benchmarking, and improving BEAM competency of Qatar construction industry and industry practitioner, and to develop a BEAM educational framework that enable embedding BEAM in academic and vocational learning from disciplinary and multidisciplinary perspective. So it's a big task, but it's quite challenging. Expected impact of the project, saving and productivity gain from BEAM can be emulated in Qatar, enable adoption of BEAM process and tools, public engagement through visualization, possibility to learn a new skill and has improved employability, and this is very important for nowadays, enable built environment graduate to enter the market with distinguished BEAM competency. And for this point, we have been always reminded by visitors to our college and our department, if we have some kind of training or a student graduating with BEAM competency, the market is very demanding. BEAM competency related to sustainable realization of assets will help to reduce carbon footprint. And I would say that point is among my main interests, because my primary field is more energy efficiency in building, but I've been working very long time with energy efficiency of building and so on, but how to introduce it into practice, this is quite difficult. But done with BEAM, I think it's quite possible. The BEAM can be a very good tool to get this, to reduce the carbon footprint. And better compliance to client requirement. Assessment process, what we do, we will be sending invitations to participate and invitation acceptance. We will then receive a link to the assessment, register an account on BEAM Excellence that is built up by Bilal, and start assessment from provided link. And then you have to complete and submit your assessment. Data collection, maybe would you like to take over? Yes.
So, thank you, Dr. Jamal. So by now you have the basic idea about the project. We have two main objectives, the benchmarking and assessment, and development of the educational framework. So the benchmarking process has to go through, you need to assess first, and that assessment is part of this data collection. So, and we are not seeking a BIM, like not BIM experts per se, anyone who is part of the construction industry. So we want to capture a representative sample of BIM competency in Qatar. That can include different roles, you know, project manager. So he may not have a big or you know, significant overlap with BIM, but we want to see what are the needed competencies for a project manager, or what are the existing competencies, and where we want to go in the future for him to have a certain extent or a certain level of BIM competencies. Yeah, so anyone from design, construction, and operation stage involved in either design, construction, operation is welcome to participate, and we're actually encouraging everyone, you know, to collaborate with us, and then so that we are able to achieve something which represents Qatar. The data is collected according to BIM competency hierarchy. This hierarchy has, you know, you see the central, the starting point is the hierarchy, and then there are tiers. There are three competency tiers. The first one is core competencies, the domain competencies, and execution competencies. Our focus is on the central domain competencies, which is about BIM competencies. And these are then divided into eight, you know, sets: managerial, administrative, functional, operational, technical, implementation, supportive set, and research and development. When you go through the assessment, all of these terms are well explained on the assessment tool, and you can even go to, we can provide the links where you can go to and, you know, actually see this hierarchy and see what's in there. So at the last, you know, the detailed level is the competency items. So the questions that you will be answering would be corresponding to those items. For example, I mean, I'm sorry if it's not too visible, but so if you talk about technical, there would be things like model management. So how do you think yourself as an expert in terms of model management? Something like this. We'll come to the scale later on, how you measure yourself on a scale at these topics. Right. So those eight competency sets are all part of the tool. You go inside each of those sets: technical, operational, functional, implementation, admin, supportive, R&D, and managerial. So, and each of them would have then the questions about competency items. So this is the scale. So, and it has, you know, two sides. One is the conceptual knowledge side, and the other is applied knowledge skill. So you can talk about, let's say, document management, you know, ability to manage documents, in a project context. So if you have been doing it for, you know, many times, you have, you know, experience, you have the knowledge and everything, so you would be at the last, the highest level of expertise, which is the expert. And then, you know, if you have no idea about how documents are being managed on a project, you would select like the zero. And, you know, you do it for all those competency items, and at the end you would see a nice figure which would tell you about, okay, this is where you are. And if you are a company and you want to improve the competency of your teams, of your people, you could use this and, you know, do the assessment at one point in time, do it in after some, introduce some training to your teams, and then do it again after you've done the training. So you could really capture where have the improvements taken place, and where do you see, I mean, you can develop your training plans if you're following this assessment. So this is what I'm talking about. So this is sort of along all the competency topics. you would see your score from that scale 0 to 4. And this is from the pilot study that we did. So you can see it's around 2, you know. We did 22 people who are, you know, related to BIM. And this is their average score across all those 55 topics. 55 topics of BIM competency, including, you know, document management, model management, all those things that you hear about BIM. So what we want to target, we want to target a big number of people that can represent Qatar, and we can have these sort of competency profiles for different roles. So we see these BIM roles, you know, emerging in advertisements, BIM manager. So if we can collect a lot of data about BIM manager and their competency, we would have something like a representative figure for them. Okay, a BIM manager should have these sort of competencies. And there it could apply to other roles, structural engineer and architect and, you know, all these industry roles that we have. So from what we collected, you saw that scale, the colorful scale, and now we collected this pilot data, and this is according to those, you know, topics. So in the technical, there is document management, model management. In operation, there is capturing and representing, you know, quantity surveying. So all these things, they are well explained. I'm sorry about the visibility, but when you go to the tool itself, and on the links that we would provide you, so you could see what does it mean. And so this is a call for action. We would like you to participate in this project because it's important for all of us who are working in Qatar. You know, we want to see them being implemented in Qatar, and we want everyone to be up to speed about it. So we would like your participation. And how would you participate in it? Okay, this is why we want to participate in it. For the success of the project, so that the research would have a significant impact for Qatar, and opportunity to be part of this new methodology. It's not implemented everywhere, and it's research based. So it's not, you know, somebody just brainstorming and coming out of it. It's backed by, you know, years of research. And it will help in identifying competency gaps and will identify target areas for improvement. So what we would like you to do ideally is to contact your either peers, or if you are in a managerial position, your teams that you're managing. And if possible, you know, ranging from 700 to 1,000, it could be a big figure, but as many as you can, we would like you to encourage them to participate in it. And so you will receive an invitation, and then you come back to us, okay, we want to, you know, be part of this study. We talk to our teams, they are happy to, you know, collaborate with you to do the assessment, and we'll update you about the feedback, how many we've collected, and we'll disseminate the results in certain way. The data would be anonymized, so it's not like somebody pointing fingers at other people that this guy knows this much about them. It's all anonymized and aggregated, and it would be, you know, kept private with us. And stay in touch with us so that, you know, we are able to make some progress. And that's it. Thank you. Okay.